people, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, today, I'm going to talk about one of the most bitter rivalry in the history of the Jamaica Constabulary Force, especially between two very senior members. And the two people in mention are none other than Mr. Renito de Cordova Valentino Adams and Mr. Mark Shields, right? Now, a lot of people didn't know Adams have that boasty name, and I don't know where Adams' parents to get that name from, but De Cordova Valentino, that's a millionaire name right there, right? But anyway, Mark Shields and Adams could not stand each other to the point where when Mark Shields started to receive threats on his life, he went as far as to say it was Adams who was sending those threats. I'm going to go into the how, the when, and the why. But before I start, please smash that like button. It's the only thing I ask people. When you come in, just please smash the like button. It helps to give the video a little boost. You send a signal to Google that, or YouTube that, people like the video and then they push it out to others, right? So anyway, back to what I was saying. Now, Renito Adams don't really need an introduction. Every Jamaican should know about Adams, right? But here's the thing with Adams. Depending on who you ask, Adams is either hailed as a top crime fighter, right, who did an excellent job, right, and was forced out of the force, or a massively overrated man with an inflated ego who didn't deliver on the numbers and whose reputation don't match his actual track record. So those are the two camps you will meet when dealing with Adams, right? Now I'm going to start with Renito Adams. And before I go into the Mark Shields thing, let me give you an interesting story. I don't know how many people know about this story. You remember the first big incursion into Tivoli Gardens when Renito Adams took a team on the Tivoli, right? And they basically came under hell and powder hose from the garden man them. Remember when the police were locked down in the old buildings and they were Renito Adams did an interview where he's saying Jamaica would pay dearly. Do you know the background of how that happened? Remember how it just turned up out of nowhere? Well, if you ask garden man, this is the story they will tell you. See, Renito Adams has always had certain allegations attached to him regarding one specific Don. And that Don is the Don from Outer East. That is East Kingston. Don't worry, I'll get into it later. Right. You'll hear the name of this Don further on down the road in this same video. So don't worry yourself. Now, garden man them will tell you, and people out of East will tell you, because this is more an industry story. The reason why that incursion happened in Tivoli is because the Don from the East used to link with Dodos, right, for certain shipments into the island. Right. At the time, Tivoli man then did have a section of the wharf for themselves. They could bring in things easy, bike, even car could come in. It was give them a thing and then bring it in for you. The Don from the East was linking with the West man them. Right? This is why I tell people in certain level of badness, only money matters. Right? Because East, the East Don a big PNP man, and the West Don was obviously a big labor right, but they were linking. Anyway, a container drop a Jamaica, full of machine, and as Vibes Cartel said, when me say machine, me no mean singer sewing machine, right? One container full of machine, and the guard man them was supposed to take them, clear them off, and send them over to the Don in the east. However, when the guard man them bust the container and realized a pure machine in the container, they decided to not hand it over. They decided they might go hold on upon it for themselves. When the Don from the east got this information, so guard man them now go hand over a machine them. It is alleged, because obviously there was never any trial for this, but it is alleged that him link Adams and make Adams know what's going on. And Renita Adams went into Tivoli Gardens to recover those weapons. So when Adams tell you that he went in there to recover weapons, he had intelligence. You know, like how Horace Chang say, my intelligence. When Adam says, my intelligence tell me that there were new there are a lot of machines in the community and I'm coming for them, he was right. But what you need to ask Adam is, who tell him that? And what link he had with those people? What was his true motive? Anyway, that's something to consider. Remember, ask anybody from West Kingston or Rockford about that story. Adams went, Adams allegedly went to collect the Don from East Kingston machine and guard the man in Tekwe. Anyway, back to the story, or back to why Mark Shields and Renita Adams didn't get along. Now, Mark Shields came from England to save the day, apparently. He was supposed to be the great white hope who would deliver Jamaica from all her sins. But of course, when Mark Shields came to Jamaica and he realized the culture of the JCF, right, he realized it was not going to be an easy road for him. However, one of the reasons why, or the main reason where why Mark Shields and Renita Adams became Puss and Dog was over the crawl incident in Clarendon. Remember that in, I think it was May 2003, right? About six officers actually get locked up, right? Are accused of going over there and lit down some 87 octanes, right? And the main target of that operation was a man by the name of Washington Chen Chen Douglas, right? Now, Chen Chen was an 87 octane, right? Do not get it twisted. I think it was actually about four of them who get lit down the day, right? May 2003, yeah, four of them including Chen Chen. But this crawl case ended up bringing out a certain Don into the spotlight and putting his name right into the mix alongside Renita Adams, right? To the point where one of the first time that Don name ever get drawn up in a public setting was for this case, because that Don at one point was going to be used by the prosecution to testify that he provided weapons to get put upon the youth them. Right? Of course, it never happened. Right? And it would be madness to think that he was actually going to do it. But at one point, the prosecution were going to use that Don, right, to testify that he provided weapons for Adams to place and the youth them after them get lit down, right, and basically paint the picture of a shootout, right. Now, when Mark Shields realized that Adams was going to bust the case, right, because the Crowley incident, again, once you go in a court of law, is not what you know, is not what you can prove. And it quickly started to become apparent that the case was unraveling and they couldn't prove that Adams and his team mashed up the youth in a cold blood, as people claimed. Remember, you know, in Crawley, the neighbors said they heard the whole thing, and the man in there begged for them life. I know. I think even the investigators found out one weapon killed about three people, right? And people were saying it was clearly an execution, right? But nevertheless, the name of that Don, who was supposed to testify that he provided Adams with the weapon, was of course none other than Danai Williams. Right. Now, Mark Shields jump out and say, if Adams gets found not guilty and put back on the force, he would leave the Jamaica Constabulary Force and go back to England. Right? And then, in an extraordinary move, Mark Shields went as far as to say that he was receiving threats on his life and he believes it's Adams who is sending them. That's how bitter they had become towards each other. Now, just like in before, I said there were two camps of people in terms of how them look at Adams, the same applies to Mark Shields. One camp look at Mark Shields as this overrated Englishman who come at Jamaica thinking him better than everybody, right? With no glorious track record in the UK, right? And didn't actually do a thing out here but collect taxpayers' money. That's one camp. The other camp has it that Mark Shields was this nobleman who came to fix Jamaica's, not just Jamaica's crime problem, but also the Jamaican Constabulary Force, but the corrupt elements inside the force prevented him from doing his job, right? So those are the two camps when it comes down to Mark Shields. But here's the thing. When Mark Shields threatened to go back to the UK if Adams wasn't found guilty, Mark Shields wasn't being honest. See, Mark Shields was never going to go back to the UK. You know why? Because Mark Shields realized that in Jamaica, he was now treated as someone from the upper echelons of society. See, back in the UK, he was just another cop, just another man. He walks down the street, nobody would notice him. He was not a famous Scotland Yard cop. First of all, in the UK, they don't really have this bad man police image. You know, like how some police in Jamaica are famous for being bad man police, like Trinity, Leng, Adams. Everybody know them name and know them face. That culture doesn't really apply in the UK. Most people can't even tell you the name of the police commissioner, much less the superintendents, right? But Mark Shields came to Jamaica and realized in the certain social circles, he was being given a certain amount of reverence and adoration that he was not receiving in the UK. But in Jamaica, everywhere you went, especially uptown, Mark Shields was being treated like a star. He got addicted to Jamaica. He fell in love with Jamaica because he can't get that in the UK. He could never get that in the UK. In the UK, he had to actually be a star. He had to be a celebrity or do something special. But in Jamaica, he could get that reverence just for existing and being who he is. Right? So when Mark Shields says he was going to leave Jamaica if Adams don't go jail and if Adams get back him job, Mark Shields, come on. Mark Shields was not being honest. Right? And from way back then, I was telling people, there's no way Mark Shields is going back to England to become another regular Englishman. When in Jamaica, he's treated like the golden child by certain people, of course, especially the more uptown people. So there was resentment in the police force. Renita Adams was looking at Mark Shields as an outsider who's coming down here, trying to tell people how to do things, Right? According to Adams, Mark Shields don't respect Jamaica and Jamaican laws. And Mark Shields is looking at it as these bunch of local corrupt cops were trying to prevent me from turning around the force. So, it's funny how even though they're such bitter rivals, if you look at their life, they're actually quite similar. As in, both of them split opinions. Both of them are either seen as overrated or saviors. Right? Both of them left the force, gone on to do private security. Both of them, even though they're gone from the force, are still regularly consulted for opinions on matters in Jamaica as it relates to crime. Right? But when they were in the force, they could not get along and they could not work together. A lot of people don't realize how close Mark Shields and Adams came to actually hurting each other. As I said, Mark Shields was receiving threats on his life. Think of this man was the assistant commissioner of police and he was receiving threats on his life. And he believed it was coming from another police officer, Renita Adams. That's how serious things got in the JCF. Right. Anyway, people, big up Patreon squad as usual. Please remember to like, comment, and share the video. Bless up.